grandfather. My grandfather used to like commenting in church, but he was old. So sometimes he would say things that would not make sense. Okay. So whenever my grandfather would lift his hand up, then it was what I was so niggas wabunyo ni tuba kulum. You see my grandmother pretending to be asleep. Pretend to be asleep. hey, it's your girl Mrs. L, and I'm back with another video. Today I'm going to be talking to you on how to become a better wife. I know that when we get married, 1 + 1 = 1, but there's sometimes when we want 1 + 1 = 2, allow him to hang out with guys, allow him to spend time with his family if he wants to, allow him to go play soccer out there. On the soccer issue, I'm not going to talk about it because a lot of women will be like, no, how can you go to the soccer? How can you go for soccer on a Sunday before washing the car? He expects me to do all those things. So give him space. You know, give him space. Allow him to be an individual. In as much as we are two, he's still one. Okay. Number two, compliment more. Men, they love being complimented. Tell him, dude, you're the best. You know, you're the best. This is about you and him. It's about building a strong relationship. Men, they have this ego. They want to feel big. Okay, make him feel. But nothing to lose, girl. Compliment more. I also feel like even in real life, can we just be positive people? Be positive. Choose to see the positive in people. Once upon a time, I was walking with my baby. Then I saw this child. From afar, I could see that there was something wrong with this child. Then he was like, hi, stop. She was even stopping me. Something said, run away. Because this child is not like, you can see that he's not okay. But something said, no, stop. So I stopped. Then he came and said, hi. He played with the baby. Then he left. He said, thank you, bye. So try to see positive in people. So I try to see positive and stop giving out negative energy. Yeah, point out something good every day. See something, the good in your husband. I think you guys have read, those who have read Fascinating Womanhood, they'll be like, concentrate on the good things. Concentrate on the fact that he's loving. Concentrate on the fact that he's a provider. Don't, because you guys, when the more you compliment and say, you know what, I love the way you hug me, I love the way you provide, you know, it's gonna make him want to provide more. Girl, stop fighting, compliment more. Okay, the next thing is get out of your comfort zone. A lot of women, when you're married, you relax, you don't care, even bathing, you don't bath, you wear the pantyhose on your head the whole day. You don't care. Get out of your comfort zone. Do things that you've never done. Spice it out. Do things that you've never done, you know. Bend, lift up your legs that way. do things that you've never done to spice up your marriage. Okay, criticize less. I know that marriages are hard. There's so much things that the husband does that's irritating you. Don't dwell on that. Dwell on the negative. I think this point is being repeated for the second time because you women, you like to criticize. Respect him in public. So when we are enduring the people, you understand, when we are enduring the people, try to not tone it down, sissy. Tone it down. I've once attended a meeting where the husband and wife, the husband lifted up his hand. They wanted to make him a chairman of some project. Then the husband said something. Then the wife was like, "Hi, Baba, nyege." She said a lot of things about her husband. She disrespected her husband during the people. Then after that, people were like, no, we can never make him a chairman because he does not even know how to control his wife. Guys, can you just learn to keep quiet? If it's in public, keep quiet or just ignore. My grandmother, so I'm gonna tell you something about my grandmom. Okay, my grandfather used to like commenting in church, but he was old, so sometimes he would say things that would not make sense. Okay, so whenever my grandfather would lift his hand up, then it was what I was so niggas wabunyo ni tuba kulum. You see my grandmother pretend to be asleep. I'm saying pretend to be asleep. She would pretend to be asleep because that guy would say crazy things, things that would not even make sense. She'll pretend to sleep, the whole church will laugh and she's sleeping. Oh, don't even go and say, Baba, hide in her pants. No. Let him be. Allow him to be whatever he wants to be. Keep quiet. Don't disrespect him in public. Those are six ways that I had today that I've shared with you, you guys. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please consider subscribing, okay? Consider subscribing and please share so that we help the algorithm to push the video so that it can reach a lot of people. The main reason behind this is to build stronger, healthier, loving, God-fearing families. It's been good talking to you guys. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.